In this video, I will show you the basics of doing searches with SNOMED and introduce you to the way search results are ranked based on a search profile. There are three ways of doing searches with SNOMED. The first one is the quick search, which you can access through this text field here just simply by clicking in it, or with the shortcut Control 4 on Windows or Command 4 on Mac. So wherever you are in the user interface, this shortcut will always bring up the quick search. The second way of doing searches is the concept filter search. So each of the concept views has a field for doing filter searches, which is here. So this is for doing searches within SNOMED CT. This is for doing searches within ATC. This one for ICD-10. So it will filter these terminology and display the results in the concept views. And the third one, which we will talk about in the next video, is the global search dialog that comes up when you click this field. And you can see it's a little bit more complicated, and this is why we'll save it for later. Okay, let's start with the quick search. It's fairly similar to what you know from doing a Google search. You just type in a term or a few characters and the results will come up as soon as you type. You can also use abbreviation, incomplete terms, or misspellings and still get meaningful results. So let me type something. Let's look for diabetes. And you see whenever I type in a new character, my search results will change, and the more characters I type in, the smaller my search results will get. Let's stick with dia for now. You see that the search results are displayed in different sections. So there's a section with two results, which is called previous choices. This means that I was looking for diabetes before, and I picked some concepts from this list, and so this is why they're displayed on top of the list. So because we assume that choices that you made before, you might want to look for these terms again. In the next section, these are bookmarks that have dia in them here, dia. And if you see down here, there's my bookmark view. These are all my bookmarks, and there are actually two that have dia in it, and this is why they're displayed up here as well, but of course not the other bookmarks. By the way, if there's nothing in the field here, if you just have this, it will display your bookmarks. Let's go back. Okay. And the next sections are the different terminology. So for dia, within SNOMED CT, SNOMED found 2,779 results. Within ICD-10, 105 results. ICD-10 Australian modification, 392. Let's get a little bit more specific. You see it already shows diabetes here in gray font. There's an autocomplete function, and it works by simply clicking the tab key. So if I do this, and now it gives me the option of doing diabetes mellitus. But let's look at the results now. You see for SNOMED CT, now we have only 299 results, so we narrowed the search. And if I do the next one, it's even less. Okay. The search does not only show you exact matches. What you see here is all exact matches. They're in normal font, but it also considers approximate results. They will be shown in gray font. For instance, if I type in lower back pain. There is no exact match for lower back pain, and therefore it shows you everything that has back pain, lower. And here it says displaying 20 approximate matches. Press Control 4 for more. So if I do this, it will give me more search results. As you can see, there's a lot of pain, back, lower. Everything was this. And if you have a term that doesn't have a lot of exact matches, it will show the approximate results as well. If I type in, for instance, lipodystrophy, you see this is normal font, and here this one is already in gray because it's an approximate match. And if I hit Control 4 again, I have more approximate matches displayed. It also works with misspellings. Let me misspell lipodystrophy. I'll start with Y. You see, even though I misspelled it, and here I missed a character completely, it still finds the term lipodystrophy. Okay. Another nice feature is that the quick search also works if you only type a few characters of each search term. If I want to find, for instance, standing systolic blood pressure, I can just type the first two characters, like standing systolic blood pressure, and here it comes up. And I picked this before, this is why it gives it to me as a previous choice or as a SNOMED CT concept. It also works if you use a different combination. So you can start with blood, pressure, standing, systolic, and it will also come up. So once you found your concept and you want to open the editor, you just go on the concept and click it, and then it will show up in the editor. If you have several options, like let's do diet again, autocomplete, you just go down with your arrow keys or with your mouse, and then you pick, just click it. So it's very easy to open this up. Okay. I want to say a few words about the way the search results are sorted. When we designed SNOA, we wanted to make sure that the concepts that are the most relevant to the users would be displayed on top of the list. For this reason, as you saw with some diabetes, we have the previous choices and the bookmarks first. But also the other results are sorted using some tricks. We use the global usage frequency. This means that terms that are used more often in practice will have a higher ranking. However, exact matches usually take precedence over frequently used concepts. This is why you see exact matches here. But the global usage frequency is part of the search tool, so more frequent terms will come up higher up on the list. It's also based on your search profile, and I want to show you what this is about. You can access the search profile by going to File, Preferences, Snow Owl, and then there's something called Search Profile. And let me open this for you. Okay, here's the search profile. That's the default profile. There you can see where the active profile is, and this can be changed. I'll show you soon. The search profile on the left side, you see there are groups of concepts. Here are your top level concepts that you already know from the previous video. There's also, you can also add reference sets to your search profile. Here it's the non-human reference set. There's an ICDT reference set. Modules, national extensions can be added as well. So it actually can get quite complicated, but I just want to give you a brief introduction to the search profile. On the right side, you see the My Interest column. Then there are traffic lights that are all set on average. This means that all the groups here are ranked equally, so there is nothing that is preferred. Then there's the option to change this, and there are actually some built-in reference sets. I want to show you what it looks like when it's changed. Let's take the first one, cardiology. So you see now the traffic lights actually have different colors. There's green, yellow, and there's red. So there's some concepts that are excluded. So in this part, non-human reference set members were excluded completely from the search results. So if you're a clinician or a cardiologist, it makes sense to suppress all veterinarian concepts and increase the ranking of the most relevant terms. And for a cardiologist, it would be terms of the cardiology reference set. And this is why this is above average, and you see it has a green light. So it's quite simple to understand. There are different search profiles for medical specialties that already come with Snow Owl. So there is neurology, mental health, hematology, oncology, and so on. If you are a clinician, I would recommend just using this one, Clinician General. Let's click it. It's actually a little bit bigger, you see, because some reference sets were added to this one because it comprises a lot of different terms. And oops, that was, we went back to the other one. Okay. It's also quite easy to create your own reference set. All you do is you just go to New and you type in a name. I can do a test right now. I would recommend maybe starting out with the default reference set. So you always have to pick an initial reference set that you change. If I hit OK, it will give me the default reference set. And now you can add reference set members. It gives you the default search profile, not reference set. You can add reference set members, and then you can change the ranking of the different groups. So if I want to have the veterinarian terms out, I go here, and then you can just open the drop-down menu and exclude concepts. Once you do that, you will see that the light comes on, the red light comes on, and so now a concept is excluded. Or I can say I want to have clinical findings displayed higher up on the list, and then you set it to above average, and then the green light comes on. And if you see now this isn't saved yet. You can see the little asterisk here. And if I hit OK, then it will save and add this profile and actually update my search preferences to this. So just change this, hit OK, and that's then your old customized search profile. But we'll go to cancel now. Okay, so much about the quick search and setting your own search profile. And now a few more words about the filter search within the concept navigators. It's fairly similar to the quick search. It starts showing results after three characters, so not one, but three. Let's type lip for lipodystrophy, and you see there's already the tree is filtered, and it shows, of course, a lot of results, so I should probably be more specific. So you have search results here, and they're actually the same as in the quick search. However, they're displayed within the tree, so you can see where your concept is actually located, what the parent concept is. You can see if it's a more general concept, which is in this area, or if it's a more precise term like this one here. And if you don't like it, you can display it as well as a flat list. There is a toggle button here. You can toggle in between, yeah? But the search results are the same. And if you want to open an editor, you just go to this one and double click it to open the editor. So it will not display the entire hierarchy anymore. Whenever there's a term here, it will filter the tree based on the search term you have here. You might be wondering why it shows Whipple's disease and how this is related to my search term. What you will see here is always the preferred term. However, snow owl searches consider every description associated with a concept. So if we open Whipple's disease in the editor, you can see a synonym is intestinal lipodystrophy, and this is why it showed up in the search results. It's actually, it was actually originally called intestinal lipodystrophy before Whipple's disease was introduced to the medical books. Okay, so much about the basics of searching with snow owl, and in the next video we will talk about the flashlight button here and the global search dialog. Thank you.